Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at how to retarget your Motion FBX files to your character in Blender. By using the AutoRig Pro add-on, you can transfer your FBX animations to any character in seconds. The workflow for importing ActorCore motions into Blender is as follows. We'll first import the motion and load the provided preset into the AutoRig Pro remapper. After that, then all we need to do is align the rest pose and retarget the motion to your avatar in Blender. When importing in a custom character, you want to rig your avatar first using the AutoRig Pro tool. This pretty much takes care of everything for you, so all you need to do then is a simple retarget of that motion to your character. The first thing we're going to do is take a look at how to import in an ActorCore motion and apply it to a character. This mic character on the screen has been rigged using the AutoRig Pro add-on. The first thing we're going to do is go up to the File menu and import our FBX motion. You'll want to make sure you have the animation checkbox checked for this. Our animation will import with a bone rig, which we can see better if we move to the side. Let's adjust the timeline slightly to better fit the animation length, and then play back to see our dancing animation. Once we've imported the motion in successfully, the next step is to retarget it to our mic character. To do so, we need to have the AutoRig add-on active, and go to the Miscellaneous tab. From there, we can open the Remap section, and set the FBX file as the source armature, and set our rigged character mic as the target armature. Next, we need to open the Mapping Preset section in order to load our mapping preset. This preset comes with the AutoRig Pro add-on. Once that's applied, you'll see the relevant retarget bones all assigned correctly. Since the source and target armatures have different rest poses, we need to select the Redefine Rest Pose button for our source character. Then, we want to select the arm and leg bones of our source character, since they have different rotation, and then select Copy Selected Bones Rotation, and copy it from our target character. From that point, we can simply select Apply, and then we're done. We can click on Retarget now, define the animation range that we want to retarget, and then press OK. From there, we can play back to see our bone rig and mic dancing in tandem. Now that we've done a single motion retarget, let's take a look at how to do multiple motion retargeting. To do this, the first step again is to import another FBX. Once we do so, let's move it beside the previous motion so we can see it properly and play back. You'll see our third rig is doing a cool Uptown Funk dance. Now for the fun stuff. Let's select our rigged character once again and go to the bottom panel to change our editor type to non-linear animation. From there, let's find our rig character mic in the action stack. We want to change the animation to a clip, so let's click the push down action button to convert it into a motion clip. From there, the process is pretty similar. We can select the second motion skeleton as our source armature, and again have mic as the target armature. Let's also select auto scale to ensure that the scaling is consistent between our rig and mic. Again, we want to click on Redefine Rest Pose and select the same arm and leg bones that have different rotation from our target armature. Let's then select Copy Selected Bones Rotation and click Apply. Once again, we can click Retarget, define our animation range, and click OK. We've now completed the second retargeting, and we can play back to see the result. If we want Mike to dance these motions back to back, then we need to again find our animation in the timeline and click Push Down Action to create another clip. From there, we can click and drag the new motion clip so that they're on the same track. If we want to blend the two clips together more naturally, we can Shift Select both of the clips and then go to Add Transition to create a nifty transition between the two motions. If we play back now, you'll see Mike first perform the initial motion, followed by a little blend into the second one. The final thing we're going to take a look at is how to rig a custom character properly in Blender. For this one, we're using the old school Blue Man character from iClone that has a different rig from our standard characters. When we import in this FBX, let's make sure we don't have the animation selected this time. Once our Blue Man character is in, we can go into the AutoRig Pro Smart section to define the mesh to use for our rigging process. If we go into the hierarchy, we can see by toggling visibility that the character mesh consists of three parts. the sunglass frame, the lens, and the character itself. We want to shift select all of these and then click on Get Selected Objects in our Auto Rig Pro Smart section. Now the rigging begins. It will begin by asking you to define the neck, so what you need to do here is just click on the base of the character's neck on the mesh. From there, it's the same process, and you'll need to define the chin, shoulders, wrists, spine root, and ankles. Once you've done that, you can simply click on Go, and Auto Rig Pro will automatically generate a skeleton from that, complete with finger and feet bones. Since we don't need the old skeleton, we can simply hide it by toggling its visibility in the hierarchy. Auto Rig Pro is excellent, however you may occasionally need to tweak the positions of your bones. In this case, we simply need to adjust the position of our character's calf and foot bones slightly to better conform to the mesh. Once we're done that, just click on the Rig tab and then select Match to Rig. The rigging process is now complete. It's a lot faster than it used to be. The next step is to bind our character's mesh to the skeleton. To do so, we can go to the Skin tab. However, you'll see that initially, the Bind button is grayed out. This is because we need to select all three of the meshes that we previously defined. Let's go ahead and do that, and then click on the now active Bind button. We can then go into Pose mode from Object mode to play around with the character's limbs. You can see that everything looks properly rigged, so we're good to go. You can follow the retargeting process shown earlier to apply any ActorCore animation to this character. And that's all there is to it. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. Hopefully you learned a lot about retargeting your ActorCore motions to your Blender characters using the Auto Rig Pro. And make sure you check out all of our other ActorCore tutorials on our YouTube channel, and be sure to visit our forums at forum.reillusion.com. I hope to see you in the next video.